Hello, friends. In a desperate attempt to get more views and people to the channel, I'm doing those boring product videos. This is what I've been using as my foot pedal. If you don't know, I do a live show. Watch it on the Mondays, where I play these guitars, and they go into the computer, and I generally use Amplitude or Line 6 Helix Native or something like that to make the guitar sounds. And I've been using this to control it. You've got four switches and an expression pedal. No, this had like a rubbery coating on it, but it came off and I've lost it, so it's just metal now. It's just metal, bare metal. And it was easy to connect USB in there, and that's it. That goes into the computer and it just works as a basic MIDI controller. And I did a video on this ages ago, and it's probably my most watched video. So I'll put a card thing up linking to that if you want to know how to use one of these to control like Amplitude and Reaper and something like that. Problem is, I mean, it's a bit limited. It's only got four thingies and the expression pedal. And so by the power of consumerism and video editing, I've decided to give myself an upgrade. Amazing. There we go. So I bought one of these. I had one of these like 20 years ago. Early on in my career, I had a Line 6 Flextone 3 as my amp, and then just one of these at front. And through the power of MIDI, and it is proper old school MIDI, as we'll see, through the power of MIDI, I could do all my patch changes and sound changes and stuff like that. And it was quite space age at the time. But this product is still on sale 20 years later for like £100. Which it always was, I think. I remember playing about the same for it 20 years ago. And I don't think it's changed a bit. But, I mean, it was absolutely bulletproof. I don't think this will be any different. But let's do an unboxing, shall we? Unboxing, look from your side. I've tried to plan this out so that you can see what we've got. What have we got? I have no idea. I have not planned this well. what's over there? What is it? Okay. Hang on, let's put it out of there. Here we go. Out of the box, it comes with a power thing. One of the things I always liked about this unit is it uses a kettle lead. Just your bog standard like computer cable. If you see on the back there, we look at the I.O. In there. Straight in, so you don't no fiddly power adapters or anything, just main straight in. It's switched as well, which is handy. And then there are basically two jack sockets here, which are like they're relay switches. So if you've got like an amp that can do channel switching, then you can plug it in here, and you can program this to switch that on particular buttons. Quite clever. I won't be using that, I don't think, although I do have a possible idea, because I might be able to use it to switch my fill light on and off for live show effects. And anyway, and then the other two just MIDI in and out, but old school 5-pin DIN MIDI connectors, so there's no USB on it. It does have, there is software online though that you can edit it with, which I'll be using. I'll put a link in the description perhaps. If anyone else has one of these, you'll find it useful. It's old school 5-pin DIN MIDI, which I have on my PC because I use the Motu M4 interface. So I'll plug that. I mean, I've plugged that in. I'll show you it working in a minute. But look, on the front, this is what we've got. Instead of our four buttons, we've got 10 labeled. This thing is unwieldy, up to 10, and then there's bank switching as well here, and two expression pedals, so whammy and volume, or who knows, you know, it's just gives me a lot more options. I think there's a number read out there you can do sort of slightly sort of like upgrading and programming stuff. If I remember, it's 20 years ago, I have to try and remember how it all works. But I just wanted to show you the product. So here it is, it's Behringher FCB1010. Doesn't cost a lot of money. This video will get me lots of views, I'm sure. We'd like to have a better look at the back. We're in 4K. So, you know. There it is. What I'll do is I'll just... I'll plug it in, but I'll leave it up here And then I'll show you how it switches the amplitude thing. Here we go. There it is. I got it all plugged in. This will be on the floor, obviously, but there you are. Old-fashioned 5-pin DIN MIDI going into my interface and the power there. That's all it takes. I can show you this. Look, now if I bring up my... there you go. Look, you see there's operating one of the foot pedals. An amplitude, there's a volume. This one's will turn on the chorus. Oh, delay. It all works. The only annoying thing is, because of the way this is set up, it's still very weird, this, right? So Behringer made this 20 years ago, and they made it for the technology that was around 20 years ago. So it's not quite right. In that to turn things over, you have to kind of have to double press sometimes, like that, to turn, if I want to turn that chorus off, look. I press twice, and it's just a limitation of it. The weird thing is someone has made upgraded firmware which you can install by replacing the EPROM chip in the device. And it's not a lot of money, but it makes it much more flexible. And what I don't understand is why Behringer haven't done that after 20 years. Because it doesn't really cost them a lot to upgrade their firmware, but they're missing a whole load of features. Anyway, it'll do for now. I mean, it'll be great. Because one thing that'll be very nice, you see, is I have a volume pedal in my mix like that. But that's like input gain. But it's nice to have another volume pedal on the end so I can control master guitar volume as well, just to sort of help me mix. So that'll be it. Anyway, that's just wanted to show it to you, really, with something that's going on. The old one, which I've thrown down there, will still be having a use because my lights can also take MIDI control. And it is handy sometimes, like not having to stop to... you know, press buttons to switch lights on and off. So I don't know, maybe I'll use this one for the lighting because it's got so many options, and keep that one for the guitar. But either way, it's just a new upgrade to the channel. So I've got one of these FCB1010. If you've got any questions about it, or anything you want to know, send me an email, thelam@lamlive.com, and we can discuss. Maybe I can send you my settings or something like that. Anyway, there you go. Just a quickie. Hit the like, hit subscribe. Come watch the live show on a Monday, 7 p.m. That's what this is really about. This is just nonsense. Anyway, peace. Lam out.